Greetings. Brother T, you have asked probably one of the best questions possible. Does God die? I understand this is really a point of confusion for Muslims. I present your answer here so that I may be able to add more scripture to prove my statements to you. If you will first understand the definitions the Word of God establishes, the answer will make more sense, brother. I just ask you to try and understand these concepts, brother. You do not have to accept them. And I'm sure they may sound confusing because you will try and use Islamic definitions for some words. But the two do not fit together. The Bible reveals that man is a three-part being. Your physical body could be considered your visible man. But your thoughts, mind, will are invisible, hidden. 1 Peter 3:4 says, "But let it be the hidden man of the heart, in that which is not corruptible, even the ornament of a meek and quiet spirit, which is in the sight of God of great price." From this we begin to see that man is a spirit that lives in a physical body. Hebrews 4:12, "For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart." From this we can further see that the hidden man may be divided into spirit and soul. Again from Hebrews 4:12, "Dividing asunder," meaning dividing apart or separating, "of soul and spirit, and of the joints," notice the parallel here, "the soul joins, and the marrow." So between the joints and the marrow, the soul joins, and the spirit is the life, "and is a discerner," or it can distinguish and decide between, "is a discerner of the thoughts in your soul," your mind, "and your intentions," your intents, your motivations of the heart. A man is a spirit that lives in a physical body. And the spirit is connected to the body by something called the soul. So this is how the Bible defines a human being: body, soul, and spirit. The body is visible. The soul and spirit are invisible. They are called the hidden man of the heart. I'll come back to this diagram later, brother. So this is how the Bible defines a human being. Other cultures and religions have other definitions, brother. But to understand the Bible's teachings, you need this definition. So, brother, let's get back to answering your question. Does God die? You and I are created spirits. God created us, so our spirit has a beginning, when God knit our spirit into our bodies. Psalm 193:13, "For you formed my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb." So this is how you and I look, brother, as created beings. Our body, which is visible, is created. Our soul, which is invisible, was created. And our spirit, which is invisible, was created. God himself is a spirit. An eternal spirit, existing outside the physical reality humans call space-time. "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God." Jesus also existed with God as God before space-time was even created. John 17:5, "And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you before the world began." Before the world began is before creation, brother. Since our physical bodies are part of creation, brother, and Jesus existed before creation, Jesus could not have had a body before creation. Therefore, Jesus existed without having a body, brother. So this is Jesus, an eternal being, no body, and his spirit was eternal. Did Jesus have a soul before creation? I do not think Scripture directly answers one way or the other, so I will not invent or conjecture. So Jesus existed with God, as God, before space-time was created. John 1:1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. So Jesus' spirit has no beginning. Jesus has always existed with God, as God. And Jesus shared God's glory with God before creation. But when Jesus came to earth, Jesus needed a body. Hebrews 10:5. Therefore, when Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but a body you prepared for me." And so God the Father created a physical body for Jesus, and a soul became necessary at that point. The only aspect uncertain is whether his soul was eternal or it was only created with his body. So this is our diagram of Jesus, an eternal being. But his body was created. His soul was then necessary, but his spirit is eternal. Now back to the answer of your original question. Does God die? The Bible teaches that to die is not the end of existence. To die is for your eternal spirit to separate from your physical body. But even that is a subtle oversimplification, brother. There is a death referred to as the second death, which the Bible describes. Revelation 20:14, "Then death and Hades were thrown into the lake of fire." The lake of fire is the second death. This is the same fear of the flames you're taught in Islam. I believe your question refers to the first death, that is, of Jesus separating from his body. After the first death, our spirit leaves the limitations of space-time. Your spirit will still exist in a state where time does not exist. So when Jesus died, Jesus did not cease to exist. Jesus' eternal spirit, the one that existed before creation, left his physical body. When Jesus died, Jesus just separated from his body and his spirit returned to his previous glory. And now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory I had with you before the world began. In Philippians 2:5, "Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon him the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men." The NASB says, "but emptied himself, taking the form of a bondservant, and being made in the likeness of men." The Holman, "instead, he emptied himself by assuming the form of a slave." The New Living, "instead, he gave up his divine privileges, he took the humble position of a slave, and was born as a human being. He allowed himself to be knitted together to a body." The Jubilee Translation, "emptied himself, taking the form of a slave made in the likeness of men, and being found in fashion." The Greek is schemati, or outward visible form, as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Imagine you can get into your car and become one with your car for a time. This is like your spirit entering your body when you are born. You travel in your body during your life on earth. When you die, you get back out of your body, out of the vehicle that you have used in this world. I hope that you are able to understand some of these concepts, brother. When Jesus died, he did not cease to exist. God did not die and cease to exist. Jesus' spirit simply left his body for the next phase of his, God's, plan. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.